It's a teardown of this CRT monitor. This unit was mounted inside of a ship's engine room. I will show you what confirms that. I found it in the TV repair shop's dumpster. This CRT monitor has only shown a single picture on the screen, and we have some nice burn-ins on that. So it's a bit hard to see the burn-ins here, but you can see some gauges and some more in the middle here. You can see on the top here, got two gauges, and on top here it says lube oil. It should show the temperature and the pressure here. And this one shows two more gauges, fresh cooling water, HT or high temperature, and the lower one is fresh cooling water or FCW, LT or low temperature. It's hard to see the upper one, but this one shows the charge air. So maybe it shows the pressure here and maybe temperature. And this one is fuel oil. We've got the pressure here and maybe some temperature or levels in the tanks. So yes, these burn-ins shows that this monitor was used inside of a ship's engine room. And it's a Moland. We've got some control and brightness here, on off switch. And if you pull this in and rotate it, we've got some more buttons in there. I have tried to turn it on, but with no success. But let's try it again and see if it turns on. Maybe you need some kind of external signal to turn it on, but let's degaussing. Yes, nothing happens. No explosion yet. Yes, it does nothing, so I think you need to have an external signal to turn it on. Maybe they do this because of some fuel savings. It doesn't draw a lot of power when the engine isn't turned on. On this side we got a bunch of screws and some kind of a mounting bracket. And on this side we got some kind of a mounting bracket here. And the heatsink. So this thing is built in into a cabinet. So you need to have some good airflow around it to cool it down. There you can see some information on the back side. In Norway. The 3-pin connector here. Some signal inputs. Access bus. And BNCs. This is not a misspelling. This is actually called Industri Monitor in Norwegian. Here's the bottom part. I will begin by removing all the screws here. We'll have a peek inside of it from this side. As you can see here, this part here should be quite easy to open to get access to the circuit board. You can see some dust here on the bottom plate. There's the solder points for the flyback transformer, and we've got a high voltage wire going here. So I wonder if that high voltage wire had attracted some dust here, like that. Yes, there is not so many bodge wires here, only this one here. It's pretty nice done circuit board. See here on the silk screen, I've got a huge flyback transformer here, another transformer up here, some heat sinks going on, and a bunch of chips up here. Here you can see them a bit better. You see where the chips are. Got some standoffs here as well, glued in. Here's inside of it, we got this control board here, we got the actual electron gun board here, we got some other control boards here, some power supply boards. On this little board here we got what looks like a diode and a like bipolar transistor. And we got another board on the back here, and of course the main board is underneath. So I'm going to remove some more screws here. And I have actually removed plenty of them, but there is more left. Yes, most of the screws are removed, as you can see here. I have never seen this many screws from a single CRT monitor before. So yes, now the front is loose, as you can see here. So I need to be a bit careful so I don't damage the tube. It's no big deal, actually. It will be scrap anyway. Let's have it like this. Yes, I removed a lot of screws now. And yes, this is not the correct way to take this apart, but I will do it anyway. Now I should be able to remove this one. And this one here looks like some kind of a power supply board. You can see these big tracks everywhere. And these rails just fall off. They're supposed to be glued, but I think they are pretty loose now. And they have been vibrating for like 20 years or even more. Hopefully we'll find some date codes later. And here we got the heatsink. This part got many attachments on it. Cables. Yes, here we go. It was just a little cable wedged in here that held it in place. It has some hinge here. So yes, it looks like some kind of power supply board as well. Or maybe this is the flyback driver. No, actually this is the horizontal driver. This goes to the horizontal coil on the deflection here. So let's now disconnect the wires. And yes, here we got the horizontal driver. Maybe I can remove this part now. Yes. And this top part here should be the picture board. Here we got the drivers for the cathodes on the electron gun. Got the green coming here, the red one here, and the blue one here. We've got some bunch of cables here going to the power supply and on the flyback board. So these cables are disconnected. And yes, here we go. This looks a bit interesting. Got the flyback transformer here. Got the four wires going through this ferrite bead here. Three of those goes into the electron gun assembly. One goes back in the board. And after that it goes via these cables up to this electron gun board again. Here you can see some information on this power supply. We got 100-220 volts input and another setting for 200-240 volts here. And it's 47-63 Hz output, got 80 volts, 190 volts. That's quite interesting voltages. Negative 15 volts, positive 12, positive 6.3. That one is for the filament. Some logic voltage here, negative 5 volts made in Thailand. And here we got the date, I think second week 96, it's like 26 years old now. And here we got the voltages that comes out, outputs here. This is a degaussing coil and this is the input. And this cable harness here went to the picture board. Oh, look at that corrosion. Yes, I'm going to disconnect some wires here. And I will come back. And of course discharging, if there's anything left. Nope, nothing left here. Here you can see some warnings on the CRT tube. Upside down, of course. I will not put all the metal parts together again. So I will go with this as it is. And for safety reasons, I need to fill the vacuum in here. So don't just put a tube like this anywhere. If it gets hit by something, it'd be like... Yes, here we go. No more vacuum in there. And you remove the potentiometers by removing the top part and unscrewing the screw in here. And you can remove the knob. Here are all the circuit boards. Here with the big flyback board here. The horizontal board, power supply, picture board. And these were the push buttons on the front. The two potentiometers for the brightness and the contrast. Let's have a closer look at these boards. Here's the power supply board. We've got the voltage outputs here, the degaussing here. Here are the PTCs for the degaussing and the relays. So one relay is to turn off the whole system. Another one is for the degaussing. Power comes in here through a fuse. We've got some filtering going on here with some capacitors, common mode chokes and inductors and some more capacitors to ground. After that it goes to this bridge rectifier and to this chip here, STR 81145. This chip here is a voltage doubler control chip. So if you have 110 volts going here, it will connect with this bridge rectifier, these capacitors, to a voltage doubler. We double up the voltage. Or if it detects 240 volts here, it will just connect the bridge rectifier directly across these capacitors with no voltage doubling. And on the other side here, we got this transformer drive transistor here. It's a flyback configuration. On the bottom side here, here's the transistor. The transformer, we got just one winding here. No auxiliary winding. We got several outputs on the transformer. Some control board here with some optocoupler. And here we got a standby transformer. It gives out like 5 volts. On the bottom part here, you can see the isolation slot going here, around and up here. So here we got this main transformer, and this is a little standby transformer, but looks like it has some auxiliary winding as well. This goes to a control board here, this one. This one also got the isolation slot here with some optocouplers, communicating what happens on the primary and the secondary side. It's a pretty large transformer to be a flyback. Here's the main board with the flyback transformer. So it's got some control chips here. Here we've got the big flyback transformer with a bunch of thin wires going to it. Look at that, there's a bunch of thin wires going into the transformer here. We've got some inductor here, another inductor. We got this drive transistor for the vertical deflection on the deflection yoke. Yes, it goes like this. The drive transistor for a flyback transformer. And if you see on the bottom here, you can see this little high voltage wire I talked about earlier. It goes to this yellow wire, which I thought went through this connector here, which goes here back to this board here. But it actually goes to some components down here instead. And this wire, this one actually goes up to a test point, CRTP test point DF. I don't know what DF stands for. So yes, this is actually a test point. So this little island here doesn't go anywhere. It's just a test point. It's a little pin going up here. So why maybe not putting the test point somewhere here near the connector instead of bodging this wire here? Yes, otherwise pretty nicely made circuit board. Got a little bodged capacitor here. Look how they have soldered the MOSFET in place. These long leads here. And here's the little PCB that connects to the cathode ray tube. Not so much on this one. Most of the parts are on the picture board. Here are the connectors that went to the corresponding colors on the electron gun. And the drivers are on the picture board. And yes, this is a pretty dirty unit. It looks very clean, but we got this black soot everywhere on it. And on this board here, we got some kind of microcontroller here. D78014YCW. Got this little crystal here. And this one went to the picture board. From the backside. No SMD components. Everything is through hole. And on the bottom here, we got another microcontroller here with its crystal. It's a TMP87CK42N, made by Toshiba. It's quite hard to find any information on these chips, but this can be a microprocessor as well. But yes, this one was connected to the picture board, but near the connectors, the input signals. With a bunch of more chips. What's underneath here? Yes, here's what underneath that, an NEC chip. And here's the vertical driver. And here's the connector which went to the deflection coil. Here's the horizontal board. The special shape on that one. This part here looks like a power supply. With a transformer, drive transistor, couple of resistors here, a relay. And on this side we got a transformer as well. It's a drive chip for it. Here we got some impedance matching relays connecting or disconnecting these coils here. And on this little board here, which went on the heatsink, we got a bipolar transistor and a diode, or actually a couple of diodes. We got some more diodes here and capacitors. And the schematic is like this for this little circuit. And the horizontal coil should be connected here. Here are the relays. And they are connected to this little board here with the inductors on. It's a bit interesting. Why do you need to have some impedance matching on the deflection coil? That's a bit strange. You should have calculated that before you built it. Maybe this unit can be used in larger or smaller CRTs. They just use the same circuits. And you can change the tube for a bigger one. So that's pretty interesting. Why did I go into this trouble making this impedance matching? Got a bunch of chips here. And some capacitors. And looks like some kind of MOSFETs. And this is the last board. It's the picture board here. Got these heat sinks for the drivers for the cathodes. A bunch of BNCs. And these are a control bus and a communication bus here. A little expansion board here. A bunch of through-hole components. No SMD. That's nice, look at that. And here are the cathode drivers. VP31N. There are one chip for each color. And these here should be drivers. Or some kind of converter for these chips here. You see how it looks underneath that. Very nice layout. Some corrosion here. Pretty skilled circuit designer. Not a single bodge wire on this one. Here are all the screws I got from that monitor and a bunch of threaded standoffs. This. That's a good portion of screws from one single monitor. Now I'm going to salvage some components from these boards. So yes, this was a pretty interesting teardown. Never opened a monitor like this before. So I hope you found this video interesting. Thanks for watching. Still wondering why there are so many wires going into that flyback transformer. This is a huge one.